Kaptorga Visual History. Today we want to talk about Viking hairstyles. Viking hairstyles are very, very fashionable these days, as seen at the TV show Vikings, of course. And we see a lot of side cuts, undercuts, braided hair, side shaved hairstyle, whatsoever. And the question is now, did Vikings actually really look like that? Now, what do we see when we take a closer look at the sources? There are not very many sources, but we have a few reliable sources directly from the Viking Age, such as depictions or figurines. Like you see here, for example, at the Oseberg Tapestry, we see women and their hairstyles. They had long hair. And if you take a closer look now on this figurine, which probably shows a Valkyrie, you see the hairstyle in detail. Long hair, combed with a knot in the neck. But also for the hairstyles of the men, we have very good sources. Beautiful sources, tremendous sources. First of all, we have a knife handle from the Swedish Sigtuna. It shows the 3D plastic of a late Viking warrior. We see the face, the head, we see he has a helmet on, a nasal helmet, which came up in the 10th century, and we see the hairstyle. Long hair, combed with a knot in the neck. What we also see is a very well-groomed beard and a very well-groomed mustache, which leads us to a very important device of the Viking Age, the comb. A comb made from layers of antler or bone. It's very important to understand that these combs are iconic for the Viking Age. They were traded around the Baltic Sea, also around the Northern Sea. There were many, many, many combs around in use in the Viking Age. They were used in vast numbers. And they show that combing the hair was very, very important. They are manufactured quite easily. You have these layers here and two outer layers, and then you have the inner layer, which in the end becomes the comb when you take bone or antler and take a saw and cut right through here. And that shows that Vikings took their time to comb their hair and groom their beards. If you now would take hairstyles like you see in the TV show Vikings with braided hair and all this, it would not make sense to use such combs. Also, these combs helped the people back then to get rid of parasites in their hair, for example, like lice or fleas. Yes. Another thing you see in Viking TV shows are the extreme, let's say, funny beards. Mighty beards, which are braided, which have pearls in it for decoration and stuff. This is also not historical. Like we've seen at the knife handle of Sigtuna, beards were groomed carefully. And another thing, as you can see, for example, here, Vikings took care of their mustache. Obviously, it was very important for a Viking to have a proper mustache. Next thing that you read about Vikings nowadays is that they bleached their hair to a very bright blonde. And it's said that there are reliable archaeological sources that they did so. But this is not exactly true. They used a soap-like substance, and it could be that this substance brightens the hair a bit, yes? But you would not be able to bleach your hair to a platinum blonde with this substance. The last thing is the so-called kohl, or the eyeliner that you see in every modern Viking TV show. The men and the women have black eyeliner like you would associate with Egyptian times. Why is that so? Maybe because raccoon eyes were very fashionable when Vikings, the TV show, came up. But there is one written source about an Arabian traveler called Al-Tartushi, who visited Haithabu or Hedeby around the year 950, which is nearly the end of the Viking Age. He wrote that both men and women wear a black substance or paint a black substance around their eyes so their beauty never fades. This is the only source we have about eyeliner in Viking Age period. Now you have to see that 950 is, like I said, nearly the end of the Viking Age. Why do I say this? Most of you will know that the Viking Age ends in 1066. Yes, okay, that may be, but the 950 or the second half of the 10th century is the end of the classical Viking raid period. So this first and second, it is not a very reliable source, because, like I said, it's the only source, and he just visited one city one time, and obviously he took part, yes, of the nightlife. If it's true that he has seen men and women wear eyeliner at this point when he visited Haithabu, then it's not said that it were Vikings. It's also not said that they wore it for normal fashion, yeah, it's just very, very questionable. And as long as we have no more evidence about this, we can say from an archaeological perspective, Vikings most probably did not wear eyeliner. Haithabu was not only an ordinary village, it was an early city, it was a vibrant melting pot of trading cultures from all around the known world. So we don't know exactly which cultural fashion Al-Tartushi witnessed there when it comes to the eyeliner. If you liked the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe it, and we will see each other soon again for more interesting videos about history.